Okay, as promised earlier, we will here be discussing about the first chapter introduction under the course filter design. So at first you need to have a basic concept about what the filter is and why it is used and what is its importance in communication and especially in filter design. So let me tell you, filters, simply a filter is a circuit. Okay, what does it do? It, you have heard this name filter in many other aspects of life too, such as water filter, right, and UV rays filter for glasses. So what does a filter mean? A filter means anything that removes unwanted things, right? The unwanted things may be anything. In case of electronics, it may be frequency, it may be signals, and in real life it may be pebbles, stones in water filter, and UV rays in case of blue cut lens, etc. So in filter design, we will mainly discuss about a filter which simply removes noise. How does it remove noise? By allowing a fixed frequency or a band of frequency to pass or either block it. So simply a filter is a circuit which either passes a frequency or blocks a frequency, passes a band of frequency or block a band of frequency. So now you have understand why we need a filter. So to remove unwanted noise in the circuit, and another is to only pass or block required range of frequency or a certain frequency. Okay. Now, as I mentioned in the earlier video, that here we will be discuss only about the analog filters. So what are the types of filters? Here are two types of filters: analog filters and digital filter. What are analog filters? Those filters which process analog signals are known as analog filters, and those filters which process digital signals are known as digital filters. So before understanding about the analog filter and digital filter, you should be familiar with analog signals and digital signals. So what are analog signals? Those signals which are continuous in time nature, means they have magnitude or amplitude for each value of time. They are continuous in nature. And what are discrete signals? Discrete signal means they have magnitude or amplitude over a fixed interval of time. So you should understand the basic difference between discrete signals and digital signals. After the sampling, applying sampling on analog signals, we get discrete signals. But discrete signals are different from digital signals. Only after quantization on discrete signals, we get digital signals. So analog signal into discrete signal by sampling, and discrete signals into digital signal by quantization. The basic difference between analog filter and digital filter is, analog filters are designed using circuit only, whereas digital filters are designed by using circuit or software. So here under analog filters, we have another two categories: passive filters and active filters. So what are passive filters and what are active filters? If passive elements such as resistor, inductor and capacitor are used to design analog filter, then they are categorized under passive analog filters. First, you need to understand what are passive elements. So let me give you a short overview of this. If any elements to which we don't need any external source or external power to operate them, they are simply known as passive elements. Example, resistor. Resistor, you can buy a resistor from market and you can measure its value and you can use it in circuit, but we don't give it a power supply to operate it. But whereas active elements are those elements which require external power supply, such as transistor. You need external power source to operate transistor. Similarly, amplifier. So passive elements such as RLC are used to design analog filter, then they are categorized under passive analog filters. And if active elements along with passive elements, means RLC along with op-amp, transistor, etc. are used to design analog filter, they are categorized under active analog filters. So again, now both passive and active analog filters may have four different categories. They are low pass filters, high pass filters, band pass filters and band stop filters. So here you should understand the term band. What do you mean by band? Band is simply a range of frequencies. For example, 20 hertz to 30 hertz band. 20 hertz frequency to 30 hertz band means it includes all the practically possible frequencies between 20 hertz to 30 hertz. Now, before going to different categories of filters such as low pass, high pass, band pass and band stop, we should be familiar with certain terms. So what do you mean by gain and attenuation? For this, let us consider a system where V1 is its input magnitude and theta 1 is its phase. Similarly, its output is V2, its magnitude is V2 and phase is theta 2. Let us denote the input as V1 sin omega t plus theta 1 and output as V2 sin omega t plus theta 2. So here gain simply means output by input, and attenuation is also output by input. So when we call this ratio output by input gain and output by input attenuation, if output magnitude of output upon magnitude of input is greater than 1, that is, then it is called gain. That is V2 by V1. If V2 by V1 is greater than 1, it is called gain. But if V2 by V1 is less than 1, it is called attenuation. So what do we call if V1 equals V2? So there is a specific term in filter design or electronics. We call it unity gain. Means unity gain means V1 by V2 equals to 1. So we simply represent it as unity gain. But as an electronics and communication engineer, or as an engineer, you should be familiar with this term, that what do we call the ratio of output upon input. In circuit, electronics, electrical and many other branches, the output ratio upon input ratio is known as transfer function. So in terms of transfer function, magnitude of V2 upon magnitude of V1, it may represent both gain and attenuation. So since we know that the gain or attenuation is the ratio of the same quantity, so it is unitless. But to give to represent it in unit, because you want to increase sometime gain of a certain device, then how would you measure it? Means sometime we increase the sound of our radio system and etc. So at that time we represent it as in decibel. So what is gain in decibel? Simply you need to represent it is in 20 log V2 by V1. This quantity gives gain or amplitude in decibel. But be careful, we represent attenuation as minus of 20 log base 10 V2 by V1. Now you might have a question in your mind, that why plus 20 log V2 by V1 in gain and why minus 20 log V2 by V1 in attenuation? It's because in attenuation, since V1 is less than V2, that is ratio of V2 by V1 is less than 1, and log of a certain quantity that is less than 1 always gives the result negative. So to make the whole quantity minus 20 log V2 by V1 positive, we use negative sign in front of it. That's all. Okay, now the another topic is ideal and practical response of the filter. At first, what is response? Response of a system means, if we change input, then how the output changes. This is known as the response of the system. So in case of low pass filter, the ideal response is shown as in figure. So in ideal low pass filter, so there is a certain frequency known as cutoff frequency. Since it is a low pass filter, you can be familiar by term low pass means it passes only the frequency band below or low or less than cutoff frequency. So as in figure, the rectangular box like structure shown is pass band. It means from 0 to omega c means cutoff frequency, it passes all the frequencies in between this band, and all the frequencies greater than omega c are blocked. So this is the ideal response of low pass filter. So if we move up to practical response of the low pass filter, it will show a different behavior. But at first, let us see how all the types of filters behave ideally. So here in next figure, high pass filter is shown. Ideal response of high pass filter, it implies that above cutoff frequency, it passes all the frequency through it, and below this is the stop band, means it doesn't allow any frequency below omega c to pass through it. So band pass filter. Now band pass filter means this filter allows only a fixed band of frequency to pass through it and blocks other frequencies. So here we have two frequencies, omega 1 and omega 2, both are cutoff frequencies. So any frequency between omega 1 and omega 2 will pass through the circuit and other frequencies will be blocked. And band stop filter, it's just opposite of band pass filter, means any frequency between omega 1 and omega 2 will be blocked and other remaining frequencies will be passed through the circuit. Remember, band stop filter is also known as band elimination filter. Now let us move up to practical response of filters. So in practical response, at first let us discuss about low pass filter. So here we have already seen that at cutoff frequency omega c, the pass band moves to stop band, means the frequencies below omega c passes but frequencies above omega c blocked. So here it is shown that it is perfect, means at omega c the amplitude of the system, means we have already discussed ideal response. Response means how output changes in response to input. So if input, let us discuss, if input is v1 and output is v2, then until omega c v2 will be constant, means let us 5 volt, but at omega c and after omega c it will be directly drop to 0 volt. But practically it doesn't happens. Practically what happens that there is a new band called transition band, means the output of the system will not directly move to 0, instead it will gradually decrease and it will only move to 0 at another frequency, or we represent it as approximate to 0. It isn't actually 0 but approximate to 0. So for example, for easy understanding, let us assume that omega p equals to 200 hertz and omega s equals to 220 hertz, and we have output voltage of 5 volt. So until 0 to omega p the output of the system will be 5 volt, but from omega p to omega s, means 0 to 200 hertz the signal will be 5 volt, but from 200 hertz to 220 hertz the signal 5 volt will gradually start decreasing, from 5 volt, 4 volt, 3 volt, 2 volt to 0 volt, and after omega s it will be completely 0. So in case of high pass filter, same process, but the difference is that at omega c stop band will not directly move into pass band, but stop band will gradually increase, means the output of the system will start gradually increasing and the system will move into pass band. So here is also a transition band is introduced. So here we represent WP is pass band edge and WS is stop band edge. So what is transition band? Transition band we have already discussed. So if transition band is less, then the circuit can move to ideal response. So the less is the transition band, the more the ideal character. Now the band pass filter and band stop filter are just the combination of low pass filter and high pass filter. So in band pass filter we can see that in ideal response the stop band, the pass band starts from omega 1 and ends in omega 2, but in practically the pass band will start from omega s1 and the output of the system will have constant value only from omega p1, and it will continue to omega p2, and then again at omega p2 the output of the system will gradually decrease and it will attain uniformity as after omega s2. So practically what happens in band stop filter, after the pass band start gradually decreasing, the output of the system will gradually decrease and it will be complete zero at omega s1, and then again after omega s2 the output of the system will start increasing, and from omega p2 the output of the system will attain a constant value. Now we have another topic, attenuation curve fold of filters. So attenuation curve fold, let us discuss about what is attenuation curve. So it is simply a graph between an amplitude and frequency where to show where and how attenuation occurs in different types of filters. In case of low pass filter, here we have already discussed that the formula for attenuation is minus 20 log V2 by V1 or minus 20 log amplitude ratio. So at omega equals to 0,
alpha equals to minus 20 log of 1, because we have assumed output ratio means P2 by B1 of our system as 1. So minus 20 log 1 equals to 0 dB. At omega equals to infinity, alpha equals to minus 20 log 0 infinity dB. So now our curve, attenuation curve, will be the I said something different before. Actually, attenuation curve is the curve of attenuation versus frequency. Means we have to know about practical response of the low pass filter to attain attenuation curve for low pass filter. So I confusedly say that it was the ratio, it was the graph between output magnitude versus frequency, but attenuation curve is actually the graph between attenuation versus frequency. So here, if we see in practical response, from omega equals to 0 to omega equals to p, the signal slowly starts to decrease. So from 0 to omega p, the attenuation will slowly start to increase. That is basically, it is just opposite graph of the practical response. So from omega p to omega s, here in practical response the signal was decreasing, so here it will increase. And from omega s, in practical response the signal was heading towards 0, so here the signal in attenuation curve, signal will start infinity. Here two different terms will be introduced, alpha max and alpha minimum. Alpha max means attenuation maximum. So where does it occur? What does it mean? So alpha max means maximum value of attenuation possible in pass band. So alpha max always occurs in pass band, and alpha minimum is the minimum possible value of attenuation which occurs only in stop band. So we should know about these terms, alpha max, alpha minimum, WP, WS, which we have discussed earlier. Now similarly, you can draw attenuation curve for high pass filter by simply putting the value of omega equals to 0 and omega equals to infinity in the formula of attenuation. So here if we see, from 0 to omega s, the signal, practical response of the signal is actually increasing. So in case of attenuation curve, the signal will be decreasing, and from omega s to omega p, the signal is increasing, so here it will decrease. So from after omega p, the signal in practical response attains the constant value 1. So here in this case, in attenuation curve, the signal will attain a constant value 0. Practically it isn't 0, but we approximately to 0. Now we have attenuation curve for band pass filter. So now if you have already drawn low pass filter and high pass filter's attenuation curve, then it's just easy, because we just have to be careful at values of omega. So if you remember the graph of practical response of band pass filter, then it will be easy for you, because it's just the reverse of the opposite of the practical response. So here if you see, from 0 to omega s1, the signal starts increasing. So in attenuation curve, the signal will start decreasing. From omega s1 to omega p1, again the signal was increasing. Here the signal will start decreasing. From omega p1 to omega p2, in practical response, it attained almost approximate value equal to 1. Here it will attain approximate value equal to 0. And similarly, the same case is for band stop filter, and you can draw it, but remember, you should know well about alpha minimum and alpha max and omega p and omega s. So in this way you can understand these topics. Now we will be heading towards another topics in another video. Then until then, keep watching our videos, and if you find any confusion in any topic and wants clarification, and if you want to learn another subjects of electronics and communication engineering or computer engineering or electrical engineering, you can comment down below, and we will soon upload another videos about it. Thank you very much. Hello guys, like, comment and subscribe to our new YouTube channel Emerging Nepali, so you don't miss any updates.